want you to go with me in scripture to 1 Samuel chapter 6, verse 6. And it reads, "And you shall not harden your hearts as the Egyptians and Pharaoh hardened their hearts, and as they mocked the Israelites, and do not send them nor let them go." Now, I picked that verse because that's always put me in a state of wonder. Hardened his heart. What does that mean? Hardened his heart. Well, metaphysically, hardened means that you make it so the spirit cannot get in. You're refusing to accept the guidance of spirit. Willful ignorance of the God principle in man's own being. Disobedience to the indwelling Christ. And that's what we do. When we get hurt, we harden our heart. We put that wall up around us. We harden it so we don't let anything in or anything out. We harden it so that we cannot accept the spiritual guidance from the Christ within. Now, we said hardening of the heart. And when we look at what the heart is, the heart is love. We all know that. We talk about it all the time, that the heart is love. The affectional consciousness of man. It is the faculty through which man receives love from being. Well, when we harden our heart, when we get hurt, we want to stop being. We want to go into a little shell. We barely exist. I mean, we've kind of like shriveled up. It's like you're not there anymore. The heart, however, is but the visible expression of an invisible center of consciousness. It is the center from which the divine substance is poured into everyone. Everyone uses his heart center when he sends forth a loving thought. But when you're in pain, you're not sending forth loving thoughts. When you're in pain, you're not being loving. You're not expressing love. So now you've hardened your heart. You won't let spirit guide you. So you won't let anything in, and you won't let anything out. How can you exist in that vacuum? You're not. You're not really existing. You're not really being fully who and what you were meant to be. You need to heal your life. And we're going to talk about healing with the H, with the E, with the A, and the L. We're going to hit it all. We're going to give you a full spectrum of how to get this thing done. We're going to hit it with a full spectrum of what you need to do from the inside and send it out. Because to heal is to make whole. To heal is to cure. To heal is to bring forth the Christ presence, the perfect Christ man, that exists within each and every one of us. That's the full potential. That's what we're here for. So healing. When we're doing healing, we want to restore to our original purity or integrity. We want to bring you back to where you're supposed to be. And the first step in all spiritual healing is to believe. You know how Jesus asked the man, "Do you want to be healed?" That was always the first question. Because all healing is based on mental cleansing. When the mind is free from error thoughts, harmony in the body ensues. Permanent healing is never accomplished until the mental cause of the dis-ease, until the error thought is removed. So when you get the healing, the thing is, don't go back. Don't go back to that same way of thinking, doing, and being that got you there in the first place. I mean, we get the healing often. We get the lesson. Well, what do we do? We go right back. We go right back to the place that got us there in the first place. We go right back to the same problem. It's almost like drug addicts. You know how drug addicts, once they get healed, and they're not in any kind of program or something like that, they go right back to taking the drugs. And the healing is just gone. I mean, it doesn't work anymore. So you have to destroy it forever. In Luke 6:45, it says, "A good man brings out good things from the good treasure of his heart. A bad man from bad treasure of his heart brings out bad things. And from the abundance of the heart, the lips speak. Now, we've all had heartache. We've all been in that place. We've all had to endure. But it's not just being there that counts. What counts is what you do about it. What counts is how you handle the pain. You know, they say that life is 10% what happens to you and 90% of what you do about it. So now here's the part of what you can do about it. Let's start out with this H, which is the heart. Take a good look at your heart. What exactly is it that you're holding in your heart? Where is the pain in your heart? Where is the unforgiveness in your heart? What is the, who is the person, place, or thing in your heart that you are holding on to with some kind of error thought? That's where you need to start from. You need to start in that place, with that person, with that thing. We've been hurt by people. We've been hurt on the job. We've been hurt by lack of money, our perceived lack of money, because you know there is no lack of limitation. So let's start with forgiveness. In the Lord's Prayer, it says, "Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us." Translation, once you let go of and once you forgive in here, then it works out there. You got to be it to see it. Archbishop Tutu said, "There is no future without forgiveness." But that's true for each and every single one of us. You can't move forward if you're holding on to what's behind you. You can't move forward if you're anchored to the past. I mean, that unforgiveness truly is an anchoring into that moment in time. You stay there. Forgiveness does not have to come with any conditions. Forgiveness does not involve actually reaching out and being able to say something to someone who you felt did some kind of harm to you. Forgiveness is for you. Forgiveness comes from inside. It's like actually trying to get someone to help you do something for yourself that only you can do. It has to be your way forward. You can't get it from anybody else. Because you can ask, you can have a condition and say, okay, I'm gonna forgive so-and-so as soon as they do such and such. They do the thing and it doesn't help. You still feel this feeling inside. And I know some of you are thinking, well, you know, I don't know how. How do I forgive? How do I do it? Well, you can't make yourself forgive someone. You can't will yourself into forgiveness. But what you can do is have a desire to forgive. Because that's where it all starts, is having a desire. And as we know, desire is of God. And once you're on that road to forgiveness, the barriers will start coming down. The walls will crumble. And here are some things that you can do when you're working on forgiving someone. Go into that stillness. See that person. See yourself forgiving that person. See yourself expressing to this person how you want them to go through life and have the best, how you're wishing the best for them. See them in that white healing light. See them healthy, whole, and complete. See them as the person you know they can be. See them as that perfect Christ man. When you see them that way, it is difficult to hold unforgiveness in your heart. Be still and hear Spirit's guidance as you're in that moment. Your heart will begin to heal. Your heart will become open. You'll be able to be the love you seek. And for the E, I say expectations and experiences. Examine your expectations to alter your experiences. Because sometimes we set the bar way too high for other people. When you are expecting someone to only do the best they can do with what they have to work with, you are never disappointed. You are just expecting them to be themselves. And you don't know exactly what themselves are. All you know is who you are. Because people will do the best they can with what they have. Albert Einstein said, "We can't solve problems with the same consciousness that created the problem in the first place." So if you're going about it constantly expecting someone to change based upon what's gone on in the past, that's like insanity. Doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different experience. I've been there, I've been insane quite often. Had to get out eventually, figured it out. They're not gonna change, I need to change, let's move along. The A in the healing is for your attitude. One of my teachers at the Barber King School of Ministry, Sam Wilson, used to say, this is the best thing that could have ever happened. No matter what the circumstance was, this is the best thing that could have ever have happened to me. And he was right. No matter what situation you find yourself in, if your attitude is, this is the best possible thing that could have ever happened to me, you will see that it really was. I mean, no matter what it is, you will see that it really was. It may appear to not be a good thing. It may appear that it was a setback. It may appear that you're moving backwards and not forward. It may appear like you're experiencing lack and limitation. But really, everything is always in divine order. Everything is exactly the way it is supposed to be. Everything is perfect just as it is. It's up to you to see it. So the A, once again, your attitude. Your attitude will always determine your altitude. You need to go in with a positive attitude in every situation and everything. And even if you don't have it to start off with, find it and get it. Find a way to see that. Find a way to shift your perspective about that situation so that you can see that it is the best possible thing that could have happened. And the L is for love. The L is for light. Be a light unto the world. Be a light in that darkness. When you're trying to get healed, healthy, whole, and complete, you need to be that light. My granddaughter has this thing that she learned in school, and I think it's so cute, but it's a Bible verse. It's in Psalms, so I don't have the exact passage right here. But her saying is, I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp onto my feet and a light onto my path. I hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against thee. Think about that. You have all this great teachings. You have a wealth of information. You have some of the very best insight delivered through this word from Spirit into your heart to help you become healed, to help you become healthy, to help you become whole and complete. Hide it in your heart. Use those teachings in your heart. Keep those teachings there so that you won't be taken over by error of thought. Be the light that you expect to see. Be that of which you want others to see you.